ओके, वेलकम टू द क्लास. ओके, आफ्टर अ वीक, नॉट आफ्टर अ वीक, ऑन सैटरडे वी हैव टेकन द लेक्चर. सो हाउ यू आर, इज योर स्टडी गोइंग ऑन? ओके, वेलकम एवरीबॉडी. ओके, डिस्टर्बिंग सॉन्ग. ओके, साउंड साउंड. Okay, friends, is it all right now? Okay, any voice breaking over there or not? Still little bit voice breaking. Okay, some network issue from my end, I think, because I'm having little very low network connection. Okay, okay, it will get clear. Okay, so friends, actually in the last lecture we have taken your fifth lesson, India and its relations. Okay, India and its relation with neighboring countries and faraway countries, that is with the globe, with America, with Russia, with Pakistan, with China, and all other SAARC countries. We have seen what is SAARC. Okay, what that organization is established for. So have you revised that topic? Hello. Also, I have given you exercises on your fourth lesson, that is United Nations. But only Jay Ahir has handed over it to me. Okay. Apart from him, nobody has still completed that exercise. So, as soon as possible, complete it. Okay, and post it. Okay, no issue, friends, but as soon as you get the time, kindly complete it. Okay, so I will just share my screen to all of you. Do let me know whether it is visible for all of you or not. Okay, this is fifth lesson from your political science, India and other countries. So is it visible? Okay, visible for everyone. So let's start the topic. Okay, so friends, in the last lecture we have completed up to the relations with the America, India and America. Okay, Sri Lanka, Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar, all we completed. Also Maldives we have completed. Then we went for the India and America. So we have completed up to the America, that is relation of India and America in different sectors. Okay, so we have seen the history of that, how it was after the independence era, okay, and how it is right now. Okay, currently India is a very big strategic nation or ally of the America. Okay, recently we have signed COMCOS agreement. Okay, also basic exchange and commodity act, that is BECA. Okay, so this is also we have. Signed with the America. Now we will see about how the relation of India and Russia was and how it is today. Okay, so are you ready for that? Okay, I hope my voice is clear to all of you. If anybody is having problem, just refresh or again rejoin. Okay, maybe problem is at their end. Okay, so let's start the topic. India and Russia. India and erstwhile Soviet Union and Russia of today have always shared friendly relations. Okay, so basically Russia, huh, जो का Soviet Union होता 1991 पर्यंत, तर रशिया हा त्याचा एक मेजर कंट्री होता. ओके, सो सोवियत युनियन वॉज नथिंग बट द युनियन ऑफ डिफरंट कंट्रीज. ओके, विच गेट डिसइंटिग्रेटेड आफ्टर 1991, दॅट इज द कोलॅप्स ऑफ सोवियत युनियन. सो वी हॅड व्हेरी गुड रिलेशन विथ द सोवियत युनियन ऑल्सो, अँड आफ्टर सोवियत युनियन गेट्स कोलॅप्स्ड, गॉट कोलॅप्स्ड, after that also we had good relations with the Russia, and also currently also we are having good relation with Russia. So let's see, in 1971 the Indo-Soviet treaty of friendship and cooperation was signed between them, and it gave great impetus to cooperation between two countries in defense and technology. So basically all of you know that in 1971 we fought war against the Pakistan. Okay, and Bangladesh was Bangladesh got independence in 1971. So it was very necessary for us to have help from other good countries, or we can say major countries. So Soviet Union was the major country at that time, but America also was a good country or the superpower at that time in 1971. But America was not on our side. Okay, America was not helping us. He was not ready for us helping. He actually helped Pakistan, okay, against us. So Indira Gandhi went to Soviet Union, okay, and signed one agreement, okay, friendship treaty with the Soviet Union, and after that we got the support of Soviet Union in the in that time in the war of 1971. So because of Soviet Union we won that war. Okay, it was very necessary that Soviet Union was with us. Only because of Soviet Union we won that war. Otherwise America would have invaded us, okay, would have attacked us at that time. So from that treaty of friendship and cooperation, so we gave importance or impetus to cooperation between two countries in defense and technology. So basically what was in that treaty, okay, to cooperate in the field of defense and in the field of technology. Okay, so this was the treaty signed by the Indira Gandhi with Soviet Union. So is it clear? Okay, the Soviet Union has also given economic and military help to India on the large scale. So basically we know that Soviet Union was the superpower at that time. So he it gave Soviet Union gave us military help also, as well as they helped us on economy also. Okay, when the Soviet Union collapsed, India tried to establish relations with the Russia. So when the Union Soviet Union collapsed, Russia was the major country in that. So we tried to establish the good relationship with the Russia at that time in after 1991. Due to the political and economic problems in Russia, relations did not improve much. So basically 1991 मध्ये म्हणजे नुकतंच रशियाचं जे काही सोवियत युनियनचं डिसइंटिग्रेशन झालं, त्यात रशिया एक मेजर कंट्री म्हणून पुढे आला. सो देअर वॉज पॉलिटिकल अनस्टॅबिलिटी देअर, इन्स्टॅबिलिटी. ओके, देअर वॉज नॉट पॉलिटिकल स्टॅबिलिटी ओव्हर देअर ऑल्सो बिकॉज ऑफ द डिसइंटिग्रेशन. द इकॉनॉमी ऑफ द सोवियत युनियन ऑर वी कॅन से रशिया वॉज नॉट गुड ऍट द टाइम. सो दॅट्स वाय द रिलेशन्स विथ रशिया इन अर्लियर टाइम्स, ओके, इट डीड नॉट इम्प्रूव्ह वेल. जवळपास 4 ते 5 वर्ष हे रिलेशन्स काही चांगल्या पद्धतीने डेव्हलप झाले नाही. त्यानंतर 1996 आफ्टर 1996
इंडो रशियन रिलेशंस बिगेन टू इम्प्रूव स्लोली, ओके, आफ्टर 1996 देर वेयर सम स्टेबिलिटी, देर आर सम स्टेबिलिटी इन रशिया, पॉलिटिकल ऑल्सो एंड इकोनॉमिक ऑल्सो, ओके. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई गेस द रिलेशंस बिटवीन इंडिया एंड रशिया स्टार्टेड टू ग्रो स्लोली. इंडिया एंड रशिया हैव जॉइंटली बिल्ट प्रोजेक्ट्स रिलेटेड टू द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ मिलिट्री इक्विपमेंट्स, ओके, प्रोडक्शन ऑफ मिनरल ऑयल एक्सेट्रा. So basically, Russia and India has good relations, okay, in production of the military equipments, okay. So we have jointly developed different projects. We have jointly developed different equipments in the field of defense, okay. We have produced them with the help of Russia. Also, all of you know that Russia natural gas also. So it also helped India in the production of mineral oil also. So I think all of you know that BrahMos missile, our supersonic cruise missile, it is number one in the world. So it is the joint venture between India and the Russia. Okay, guys. Okay, is it clear now? Okay, so basically we have seen the relations between India and Russia. So स्वराज्याच्या काळापासून ऍक्च्युली आपले रशिया सोबतचे किंवा सोव्हिएत युनियन सोबतचे जे काही संबंध आहेत ते चांगले होते. इवन इन 1971 इंदिरा गांधी साइंड ट्रीटी, ओके, ट्रीटी ऑफ फ्रेंडशिप विथ दी सोव्हिएत युनियन ऍट दॅट टाइम, बिकॉज सोव्हिएत युनियन वॉज सुपर ओवर ऍट दॅट टाइम अँड वी इंडिया was willing to fought the war against Pakistan. So India was wanting help from the Soviet Union in the military and defense sector. So that's why from that time there was good relations with India and Soviet Union. But in 1991 Soviet Union get disintegrated, okay, Russia come as a major country in the Soviet Union, okay. So India tried to develop good relations with the Russia, but there was political instability in the Russia, also economy was not that much good. That's why in earlier times the relations did not grow very well, but after 1996, after the stability in the Russia, the relations in with India and Russia started to improve slowly. After that we cooperated each other in different sectors like production of the mineral oil, also the production of different defense equipments. Okay, so this is the relation between India and Soviet Union, not Soviet Union, it is between Russia and India. So any doubt in this, guys? Okay, no doubt. Let's take the next topic, that is India and European nations. सो बेसिकली युरोपियन नेशन्स म्हणजे युरोप हे जे काही कॉन्टिनेंट आहे, तर या युरोपचे जे कॉन्टिनेंट आहे युरोपियन युनियन असं म्हटलं जातं, ओके, बेसिकली. तर युरोपमध्ये युरोपियन युनियन म्हणून एक कॉन्सेप्ट आहे किंवा त्यांचा एक ग्रुप आहे, आणि युरोपातील जवळपास 27 ज्या कंट्री आहे या युरोपियन युनियनच्या मेंबर आहेत, ओके, 27 कंट्रीज जवळपास. त्यातून आता जो काही ब्रिटन आहे, ग्रेट ब्रिटन, ओके, हा त्यातून बाहेर पडलाय, ओके. He is no more the member of European Union. He is the separate country right now. There are trade relations between European nations and India. Okay, European nations sobat aple relations he mukhyatva vyapari sambandh ahe, okay. Trade, okay. We import something from them, okay. They import something from us. We export something to them, they export something to us. So this is nothing but the trade. Germany and France invest on a large scale in the field of technology in India. So basically European Union kyo European countries madhe mukhya desh konte konte ahet, tar Germany ahe, France ahe, okay, even Great Britain pan ahe, parantu sada Great Britain ha European Union cha bhag nahi ahe. Tar basically Germany ani France he far mothe country ahet, okay, tyanni bharatamadhe ya country ne जे काही टेक्नॉलॉजीचे सेक्टर आहे, ओके, इन द फील्ड ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी दे हॅव इन्व्हेस्टेड टू मच. Apart from this, India gets the technology of production of weapons from European nations. Okay, we also know that European countries are technically very advanced, technologically very advanced. So whether it is in the field of science, technology, defense, okay, mining, etc. Okay, so whatever it may be, they have invested too much in the R&D. So they have good technology, and they are helping India for building India's own production of the weaponries or the defense equipments. So basically, European countries are helping us. They are providing the technology for us in the field of defense sector. India is a major exporter in the field of engineering and information technology. Okay, Mitranno, IT, आपली जी काय आय टी इंडस्ट्री आहे, ओके, इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी, ही जगात सगळ्यात मोठी आहे. ओके, सो दॅट्स वाय आपली इंजिनिअरिंग आणि इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी ही जी काय फील्ड आहे, आय टी इंजिनिअरिंग. ओके, सो इट इज व्हेरी बिग इन इंडिया. दॅट्स वाय द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ आय टी इंजिनिअरिंग इंडिया एक्सपोर्ट्स टू द युरोपियन कंट्रीज. बोथ हॅव द ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह ऑफ फर्मनेस ऑन द फ्री ट्रेड. सो बेसिकली युरोपियन कंट्रीज अँड इंडिया, they are agree with each other that we are going to improve our relations, we are going to increase our trade with each other. Okay, we are going to increase the free trade or relations with us. They are moving towards that. Indian European nations are cooperating in other areas as well. So Indian European nations वेगवेगळ्या area मध्ये एकमेकांना cooperate करतात, सहकार्य करतात. ते कोणकोणते आहेत? Several treaties have been signed in the field of climate change, clean energy, defense production, disaster management, security of airspace and terrorism. So basically these are the some sectors, that is some terrorism issue, security issue in this space, also disaster management, clean energy, that is solar energy, wind energy, okay, tidal energy, the climate changing over there. So the India is cooperating with the European countries. They are cooperating with us to find the solution for the clean climate. Okay, so these are different fields. And recently France is our major partner in the field of defense. Okay, we have taken Rafale aircrafts just now from the France. So before that, MiG 2000, okay, Mirage 2000, okay, Mirage 2000 was the aircraft that we took from the France. Okay, also different types of submarines that we have taken from the France. Okay, am I audible now, friends? Okay, so you missed something that I have taught you. Okay, okay. Okay, this cooperation is very important from the point of view of India's development. So friends, European Union, the countries which are in the European Union, so these countries are developed countries. Okay, almost all the countries that are in the European continent, okay, or European Union, all these countries are developed countries. And all of you know that our country is currently developing country. Okay, so in which phase we are right now, European countries has already passed through. Okay, aapla desh aata ja stage madhe aahe. Okay, ya stage madhun European countries already pass zalela ahet. Okay, so basically this agreement or this cooperation with the European Union, okay, India's cooperation and their cooperation with us is very important from the point of view of our development, because we are still developing country. Okay, we need we have to achieve too much. Okay, still, so it is very important that is the cooperation is good with European nations also. So friends, this was the India and European countries. Okay, any doubt in this? You can ask me without any hesitation, no issue.
Because I am here to clear your doubts only, okay?
Okay. Now we will see what are or how are our relations with the African countries. Okay, am I audible to everyone? Okay. Okay, event the continent of Africa. Okay, Africa is a big continent. Okay, Africa is also one of the big continents. India has continuously taken steps to build cooperation between India and the continent of Africa. Okay, apla India is west side la jo kai continent ahe. Okay, African continent. So basically, India has always tried to have cooperation with the countries that are in the African continent. Okay, there are major too many countries in the African continent. Okay, because the African continent is very big also, but the development of the continent or the countries in that continent is very less. Okay, all of you know that Uganda, Sudan, okay, Kenya. So there are many countries, okay, in the African continent, but these people are very poor, we can say. Okay, let's see. Having close relations with Africa will be beneficial from the point of view of both. Okay, तर आफ्रिका सोबत आपले चांगले संबंध असले पाहिजे हे दोघांच्या दृष्टीने गरजेचं आहे. ओके, त्यांच्या दृष्टीने पण आणि आपल्या दृष्टीने पण. बिकॉज स्टील वी आर ऑल्सो डेव्हलपिंग अँड दिस कंट्रीज दॅट आर ऑल्सो पुअर कंट्रीज दॅट कंट्रीज आर ऑल्सो ट्राईंग टू इम्प्रूव्ह देअर इकॉनॉमिकल एज वेल एज सोशल सिच्युएशन कंडिशन. मेनी कंट्रीज इन द आफ्रिका आर डेव्हलपिंग रॅपिडली. सो बेसिकली दे आर ऑल्सो द ग्रोथ रेट इज व्हेरी हाय ऑफ सम कंट्रीज. Ethiopia, you can say. Okay, there are many countries. India had shown its readiness to help in the all-round development of African youth. Okay, Africa मधील जे काही तरुण लोक आहेत, ओके, वेगवेगळ्या कंट्रीज मधले, तर त्या सर्वांना एक प्रकारे हेल्प करणं, ओके, त्या सर्वांना एक प्रकारे मदत करण्यासाठी इंडिया इज ऑलवेज रेडी. इंडिया इज ऑल्सो अग्रीड टू गिव्ह इकॉनॉमिक हेल्प and even grants to bring about development in different areas like technology, agriculture, tourism, etc. Okay, so India is somewhat more developed than the African countries. So that's why India has good technology. Okay, India has good society. So how India has achieved all these things? Okay, India is also helping to achieve the same thing for the countries in the African continent. Okay, even India is also giving some technology in the field of agriculture, tourism. Okay, also have provided some grants, means some help in the form of money. I hope you people might have some Discovery Channel, okay, National Geographic Channel, History TV 18. Okay, so in that you might have seen the jungles of Africa, okay, forests of Africa, different type of animals, birds, reptiles over there. So basically African continent is rich of the natural resources or natural habitats. Okay, so for the tourism point of view, it is very important, and India doing the same, helping in the field of tourism also. Okay, India's energy needs can be fulfilled by the energy rich countries like Egypt, Nigeria, Angola and Sudan. So basically Sudan, Egypt, Nigeria and Angola, these countries have good amount of mineral oil. Okay, they have crude oil in that countries. So India imports that crude oil from these African countries, okay, listed over here. So that's why they help us, African countries helps India to meet its energy needs.
India is making efforts to increase trade with Africa. The summit conference of India and Africa was held in 2015, and the representatives from all 54 African nations attended it. In this conference, discussions were held on many global issues, for example, climate change, terrorism, privacy, etc., piracy, okay, etc. So, basically, we have one group, okay, with the African continent. So that summit of this 54 country, okay, there are almost 54 African countries in that group, including India. So in 2015, this summit conference was held between these countries and India. So in that conference, all the members of this group participated, okay. So they discussed on different issues going in the world. That is climate change, okay, whatever the different things that are causing climate to be changed, okay. Even the terrorism issue, all of you know, terrorism is a global issue, global problem, okay. Also the piracies, okay, so technology transfer, etc. Even we can say the intellectual property, etc. So all these things are in the piracy. So overall, we are improving the relations with the African countries. Okay, guys. Sorry, I didn't saw your comments. Am I audible right now? Okay, today in this area there is a weak network connection. That's why when I present the screen, I think it is making burden. Okay. So, shall I explain the topic once again? That is our relations with African continent. Okay, Maitreya, still whistling sound is coming. Hello. Okay, am I audible to everyone? Still, I have a problem of same. It's coming. Okay, for you also. Okay, let's do one thing. I will just refresh the network and I will again join all of you. Okay. So, okay, guys, am I audible now? Okay, audible to everyone? But still the problem is continuing.
So,
am I audible? Still whistling sound is coming to you. Still, I don't know what's happening. Okay, audible. If the sound is not clear, then I cannot continue, guys, because there is no use of it. Okay, wait for 2 minutes, okay? 2 to 5 minutes. I'll just
Hello guys, am I audible? Okay, any whistling sound? Okay, we'll continue again. Okay, so guys, basically we have just covered how our relations are with the African continent. Okay, countries in the African continent. So basically African countries in the African continent are not that much developed. Okay, among them India is a developed country, we can say. And India is trying to help them, okay, to improve their condition or economic power. Okay, India is helping them. Also, the African continents are. No, I haven't shared screen yet. Okay, I have not shared screen. Okay, it will be visible now. Okay. So I have. Sorry. Basically, India have helped African countries in the field of technology, in the field of agriculture, in the field of tourism. Okay, because tourism is a good industry. Okay, there are too many tourist places in the African continent, different countries. Okay, any doubt in this too, guys?
हेलो, एनी डाउट इन दिस टॉपिक? ओके, एंड व्हाट अबाउट माय वॉइस? ओके ओके, देन लेट्स सी द स्क्रीन. ओके, हियर इज, वी हैव सीन इंडिया एंड कॉन्टिनेंट ऑफ अफ्रीका. वी कंप्लीटेड इट. नाउ वी विल सी इंडिया एंड द इंडो पैसिफिक एरिया. सो स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू यू, इज इट? ओके, इट इज ऑल. लेट्स सी, द इंडो पैसिफिक एरिया इंक्लूड्स कंट्रीज लाइक जापान, ऑस्ट्रेलिया, न्यूजीलैंड एंड नॉर्थ ईस्ट एशियन नेशंस. ऑल ऑफ दीज. ओके, इंडो पैसिफिक म्हणजे कोणता एरिया? तुम्ही जर नॉर्थ सॉरी साउथ ईस्ट रिजन जर घेतला तुम्ही, ओके, साउथ ईस्ट एशिया, तर त्यामध्ये जवळपास सगळ्या कंट्री येतात. कोणकोणत्या? इंडोनेशिया झालं, मलेशिया झालं, सिंगापूर झालं, ओके, इवन जपान, फिलिपाईन्स, न्यूझीलँड, ऑस्ट्रेलिया. सो ऑल दॅट बिल्ड, ओके, इन द पॅसिफिक ओशन अँड इन द इंडियन ओशन. सो दॅट इज नथिंग बट द इंडो पॅसिफिक एरिया. ऑल ऑफ दिस हॅव क्लोज ट्रेड रिलेशन्स विथ इंडिया. ओके, दिस कंट्रीज हॅव गुड रिलेशन्स विथ इंडिया इन द फील्ड ऑफ ट्रेड. Many companies have many companies there have invested in India. Treaties have been signed between India and Australia about social security, extradition of criminals, the mission against smuggling of drugs, terrorism, art and culture. Japan cooperates in the with India in basic facilities, economic cooperation, information technology, atomic energy and railways. Okay. तर मित्रांनो, आपला जो ऑस्ट्रेलिया सोबत जे रिलेशन्स आहे, ओके, ऑस्ट्रेलिया इज अ कॉन्टिनेंट, ओके, इट इज नॉट ओनली अ कंट्री, इट इज वन कॉन्टिनेंट. ओके, ऑस्ट्रेलिया इज अ कॉन्टिनेंट. तर मित्रांनो, ऑस्ट्रेलिया सोबत आपले कोणकोणते संबंध आहेत? वी हॅव गुड ट्रीटीज, ओके, ट्रीटीज साइन बिटवीन इंडिया अँड ऑस्ट्रेलिया अबाउट सोशल सिक्युरिटी, एक्सट्रॅडिशन ऑफ क्रिमिनल्स. म्हणजे काय? सपोज आपल्या देशात एखादा क्रिमिनल जर एखादा काही गुन्हा करून गेला, ओके, काही ऑफेन्स करून तो ऑस्ट्रेलियात जर गेला, तर तिथून त्याला इकडे आणण्याचं जे काही प्रत्यार्पण त्याला म्हटलं जातं, ओके, मराठीमध्ये प्रत्यार्पण, तर त्याचं एक्स्ट्रॅडिशन जे आहे, तर त्यासाठी दोन्ही देशांमध्ये एक ट्रीटी आवश्यक असते. ओके, अदरवाइज दे डू नॉट सेंड बॅक दिस क्रिमिनल्स टू अस. ओके, सो वी हॅव दॅट टाइप ऑफ ट्रीटीज विथ ऑस्ट्रेलिया. ऑल्सो द मिशन अगेन्स्ट स्मगलिंग ऑफ ड्रग्स. ओके, इट इज अ ग्लोबल इश्यू, स्मगलिंग ऑफ ड्रग्स, टेररिझम, आर्ट अँड कल्चर. ओके, सो वी हॅव गुड ट्रीटीज अँड अग्रीमेंट्स विथ दी ऑस्ट्रेलिया इन दिस फील्ड. येस, लाईक विजय मल्ल्या. बट फ्रेंड्स, वॉट डू यू नो वन थिंग? डू यू नो वन थिंग दॅट विजय मल्ल्या हॅज सम प्रॉपर्टी, ओके, अँड ही कॅन इन्व्हेस्ट दॅट प्रॉपर्टी ऑर इन दी ग्रेट ब्रिटन, ओके, इन दी लंडन, इंग्लंड. सो दॅट्स वाय दी गव्हर्नमेंट ऑफ ग्रेट ब्रिटन इज नॉट गिविंग बॅक विजय मल्ल्या टू इंडिया बॅक, ओके, अगेन, बिकॉज देर इज बेनिफिट फ्रॉम दी विजय मल्ल्या टू दी ग्रेट ब्रिटन. बिकॉज इफ ही इन्व्हेस्ट इन द ग्रेट ब्रिटन, देन इट कॅन जनरेट द एम्प्लॉयमेंट, ही कॅन गिव्ह टॅक्सेस टू ब्रिटन. ओके, सो दॅट्स वाय दे आर नॉट एक्सट्रॅडिटिंग विजय मल्ल्या. ओके, या इट कॅन सील इज प्रॉपर्टी इन इंडिया, ओके, बट मे बी ही हॅव ट्रान्सफर्ड सम प्रॉपर्टीज, ओके, सम मनी टू दी अकाउंट्स, बँक अकाउंट्स इन दी ग्रेट ब्रिटन. ओके, दॅट कॅन बी द केस, बिकॉज दिस पीपल, ओके, दिस पीपल आर व्हेरी क्लेव्हर. त्यांना माहीत असतं कर कसा वाचवायचा, टॅक्स वाचवायचा कसा, ओके, ब्लॅक मनी कसा करायचा, ओके, इवन हाऊ टू डिफॉल्ट, मेक डिफॉल्ट इन द पेमेंट ऑफ द लोन. ओके, लोन पेमेंट डिफॉल्ट कसं करायचं, या सगळ्या गोष्टी यांनी केलेल्या असतात. त्यामुळे आपला देश सोडून जाणं काय त्यांना अवघड नाही. ते त्यांच्यासोबत काही प्रॉपर्टीचे अरेंजमेंट ऑलरेडी करून ठेवतात. सपोज जर ब्रिटन मध्ये गेला तर तिथे कुठे इन्व्हेस्ट करणार किंवा काही, हे ऑलरेडी त्याने आधी सेट करून ठेवलेलं असतं. सो दॅट्स वाय इवन बाय फ्रीजिंग द प्रॉपर्टीज ओके, किंवा बाय सेलिंग द प्रॉपर्टी देर इज नॉट टू मच थिंग दॅट हॅपन्स ओके. नाउ वी हॅव सीन अबाउट द ऑस्ट्रेलियन इंडिया, नाउ लेट सी वॉट टाईज जपान अँड इंडिया हॅज. जपान कोऑपरेट्स विथ द इंडिया इन बेसिक फॅसिलिटीज, इकॉनॉमिक कोऑपरेशन, इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी, ऑटोमिक एनर्जी अँड रेल्वेज ओके. तर आपल्यासोबत जपान ही एक डेव्हलप्ड कंट्री आहे ओके. जपान इज अ थर्ड इकॉनॉमिक सुपर पॉवर ओके, इट इज थर्ड रँक्ड थर्ड. जवळपास 5 ते 6 ट्रिलियन डॉलरची ही जपानची इकॉनॉमी आहे. जपान इज अ व्हेरी स्मॉल कंट्री, व्हेरी स्मॉल कंट्री, अँड दॅट टू हॅव्हिंग डिफरंट आयलँड्स ओके, नॉट अ सिंगल पीस ऑफ लँड, मेनी आयलँड्स इन्क्लुडिंग मेक्स दॅट कंट्री ओके. सो वी हॅव रिलेशन्स इन द बेसिक फॅसिलिटीज, इकॉनॉमिक ऑपरेशन, आर्थिक संबंध आपले आपले त्यांच्यासोबत आहेत. इवन आय टी सेक्टर आहे, इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी ओके. जापान इज टेक्निकली व्हेरी ऍडव्हान्स ओके, टेक्नॉलॉजिकली व्हेरी ऍडव्हान्स कंट्री इन द वर्ल्ड. नाव जपान हॅज अग्रीड टू एक्सटेंड कॉपरेशन अँड टेक्नॉलॉजिकल हेल्प टू इंडिया इन द डेव्हलपमेंट ऑफ सिक्युरिटी ऑफ कोस्टल एरियाज ओके. मित्रांनो, जपान हा एक आयलँड आहे ओके, जपान एक कंट्री एक आयलँड आहे. सो ऑल द जपान हॅज इट्स कोस्टल लाईन ओके, व्हेरी बिग कोस्टल लाईन. सो दॅट्स वाय इट इज हेल्पिंग इंडिया हाऊ टू प्रिव्हेंट अ टेररिस्ट अटॅक थ्रू द कोस्टल लाईन्स ओके, हाऊ टू सिक्युअर द कोस्टल लाईन. सो वी आर गेटिंग द हेल्प फ्रॉम द जपान इन दॅट फील्ड ऑल्सो ओके. अँड ऑल्सो जस्ट फ्यू इयर्स आय गो वी हॅव साइन द अग्रीमेंट ऑफ सेटिंग द बुलेट ट्रेन इन द इंडिया ओके. आपल्याला बुलेट ट्रेन स्टार्ट करण्यासाठी मदत करत आहे ओके. इवन जपान हॅज प्रोव्हाइडेड अस द लोन फॉर दॅट. 80% ऑफ द लोन ऑफ दॅट बुलेट ट्रेन प्रोजेक्ट ओके हॅज प्रोव्हाइडेड बाय द जपान फॉर 50 इयर्स. जॉईंट नेव्हल एक्सरसाइजेस आर कॅरीड आउट बिटवीन द नेव्हीज अँड द कोस्ट गार्ड ऑफ द बोथ कंट्रीज ओके. आपल्या आणि जपानमध्ये कंटिन्युअसली ओके, कंटिन्युअसली जपान आणि आपल्यामध्ये नेव्हल एक्सरसाइज होत असतात. इवन कारण त्यांचा इनेमी पण चायना आहे, आपला इनेमी पण एक चायना आहे मिलिटरी, इफ वी सी इन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू ऑफ मिलिटरी ओके. चायना इज अवर इनेमी, दॅट इज ऑल्सो इनेमी ऑफ जपान. दॅट्स वाय वी आर कोऑपरेटिंग विथ इच अदर इन द फील्ड ऑफ डिफेन्स मिलिटरी ओके. इन दॅट वी कंटिन्युअसली हॅव मिलिटरी एक्सरसाइज, ऑल्सो द नेव्हल एक्सरसाइजेस विथ द जपान ओके. इवन करंटली वी आर गोइंग टू फॉर्म वन ग्रुप दॅट इज कॉलिंग क्वाड ओके. 4 मेंबर्स आर इन दॅट ग्रुप, ऑस्ट्रेलिया, जपान, अमेरिका अँड इंडिया. सो बेसिकली दिस कंट्रीज आर हॅव्हिंग द थ्रेट फ्रॉम द चायना. सो दॅट्स वाय we are forming that group. It is not official yet okay that group is formed, but still we are moving towards that. Yes friends, that is Andaman and Nicobar Islands were basically captured by the Japanese force okay. So during the Subhas Chandra Bose okay, in their period before the independence okay, they gifted us, I'm not sure about that. Jay, I will tell you in the next lecture, okay? Now see India and Southeast Asia. How our relations are with the Southeast Asian countries? Southeast, okay? थोडक्यात आपलं जे काही नॉर्थ ईस्ट कंट्रीज आहे, आपले नॉर्थ ईस्ट जे काही स्टेट्स आहे त्यांच्या पलीकडे ज्या कंट्रीज आहे वेगवेगळ्या, त्या त्यांच्याबद्दल आपण बघणार आहोत. इंडिया हार्ड ए व्हेरी India has had very cordial relations with Southeast Asian nations like Indonesia, Malaysia, Singapore, Philippines, Thailand, Myanmar, Vietnam, Laos, Cambodia and Brunei. Okay, so all these countries are in the southeast of the Asia. जो का एशियन कॉन्टिनेंट आहे त्याचा साऊथ ईस्ट जो पार्ट आहे तर त्या पार्ट मध्ये या कंट्रीज आहे. तुम्ही जर मॅप जर बघितला ओके, इफ यू see the map, देन यू कैन सी हियर म्यांमार, ओके, थाईलैंड, बैंकॉक, थाईलैंड, ओके, मलेशिया, ओके, नॉट अ टोटल मैप मैप इज गिवन हियर, बट यू कैन एटलीस्ट हैव एन आइडिया, ओके, यू कैन गेट द आइडिया वेयर दिस कंट्रीज आर लोकेटेड. ओके, इंडिया बेसिकली इंडिया दिस कंट्री. There are many countries in South Asia, Philippines, Thailand, Myanmar, Malaysia, Indonesia, Singapore, Vietnam, Laos, Cambodia, okay, Brunei. After 1991, India changed economic policy and the free market economy. Okay, Bharat ne 1991 mein jo kai economical reforms ke liye, tar apan socialist economy sodun, apan free economy kade ek prakare vatsal ke liye. After that, the trade relations with Southeast Asian nations have grown. त्यानंतर साऊथ एशियन्स ज्या कंट्री आहे, साऊथ ईस्ट एशियन्स कंट्री, तर त्यांच्यासोबतचे आपले जे संबंध आहेत चांगल्या प्रकारे सुधारले, चांगल्या प्रकारे वाढले. ओके, लुकिस्ट पॉलिसी. ओके, बेसिकली दीज कंट्रीज आर लोकेटेड टू द ईस्ट साइड ऑफ द इंडिया. Okay, so that's why the policy which is regarding to this country, okay, regarding to increase the relationship with this country is nothing but the look east policy. म्हणजे पूर्वेकडे बघा असं त्या पॉलिसीला नाव दिलेलं आहे. लुक ईस्ट वॉज मेड फर्दर मोर एक्ट. ओके, इट इज नाउ नोन एज एक्ट ईस्ट पॉलिसी. ओके, तर बघा ही आपली पॉलिसी होती, सेंटर मोदी ऑफिस आहे. ओके, तर त्यानंतर त्यांनी ऍक्च्युली जस्ट अदर ओके स्टार्टेड टू ऍक्ट इन कंट्रीज ऑफ दी ओके दिस अग्रीमेंट वाढवले. ओके, सो दिस इज नथिंग बट ऍक्ट ईस्ट पॉलिसी. द वेस्ट एशियन कंट्रीज आर प्राइम सप्लायर ऑइल अँड नॅचरल गॅस. आता वेस्ट एशियन कंट्रीज कोणते आले, जे गल्फ कंट्री, ओके, कंट्रीज गल्फ कंट्री, सो दीज आर इन्क्लुडेड इन द वेस्ट ऑफ द इंडिया, West Asian countries. India Gulf countries, Arabian countries, Asia countries, okay, even some part of the Africa. So these are rich with the mineral oil, resources of oil. Even has actually had relation with this country. तर आपली जे काही एनर्जी जवळपास 80% ऑफ आवर इट बाय दिस कंट्रीज, वेस्ट कंट्रीज. ओके, वेस्ट एशियन कंट्रीज. इंडिया इम्पोर्ट्स ऑइल फ्रॉम इराण, बहरीन, कुवैत, सौदी अरेबिया अँड युनायटेड अरब इमिरेट्स. We get modern technology for agriculture and defense equipment from Israel. Okay, Israel is a very small country. Okay, but Israel is technologically very advanced. It is a developed country, one of the developed countries in the world. Okay, technology in the field of agriculture. Okay, there is no raining in the Israel. कारण हा जो काही area आहे, हा एक वाळवंटाचा भाग आहे. Okay, desert area in the Israel. So that's why there is very less raining. Having very less rainfall over there, still Israel has maintained its water resources very well. Okay, India has maintained, so that's why we're getting the technology from the Israel in the field of defense, in the field of agriculture. They are technologically very advanced in these fields. May also many Indian lives live in the Israel for their jobs or businesses. Okay, business and job study. India के लिए बड़ी चीज़ का ओके इट इज ओके नाउ हेलो ऑडिबल एम ऑडिबल या बिकॉज ऑफ दैट कॉल एक्चुअली आई हैव एक्टिवेटेड डू नॉट डिस्टर्ब बट स्टिल इट इज शोइंग द नोटिफिकेशन आई डोंट नो व्हाई बिकॉज वेन एवर आई स्टार्ट द लेक्चर आई एक्टिवेट दैट डू नॉट डिस्टर्ब बटन ओके बट स्टिल The call is coming. I don't know why. Okay, so Prince, we are studying about the West Asian countries, that is Gulf countries, Arab countries, and these countries are full of the resources of natural oil, natural gas, mineral oil. Which are these countries? These countries are Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates, Kuwait, Bahrain, Iraq, Iran, even Israel. Okay, so Israel is a technologically advanced country. It is a developed country. Okay, we take the technology from them in the field of agriculture and the defense sector. Okay. They so then business this is by the idea okay. It has Indian object of to maintain friendly relations with relations help each other bridge development of India well other countries or others Bharat ji said it's a mudesh ka hai to good relations आपल्या देशाचा विकास करून सोबत वर्ल्ड इन नेक्स्ट चॅप्टर वी शॅल स्टडी सम इम्पॉर्टंट इश्यूज थोडक्यात how its relations are with the other countries in the okay in the global so in next chapter will be international relations so guys do you have this guys so tell me which topic I repeat again oh okay hello friends am I audible now
Okay, guys, actually, you can leave the class for today, okay? And in the next class, if you have some doubts or the topics that I should repeat, please tell me, okay? I will conduct that on the Saturday's lecture, okay? So you can leave the class now, no issue. Okay, goodbye to everyone.